basically, these are several years old, actually 3 years old, so here's another cicada. And they all have been cleaned and processed, and so the wings themselves.
It is jokingly called the freezer of death.
So we actually use them. Here's the brood twos. These are the ones that were hatched last year from Greensboro. So you see they're orange.
But it's hoped these insects in cold storage will provide some insight into nanoscience. That's the science of super small things. Nanoscience is also the new world of research at the University of North Carolina, Greensboro, and at the Joint School of Nanoscience and Nanoengineering. That's an academic collaboration between UNC Greensboro and the University of North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University.
Flying insects have been around for 400, 450 million years. And so during the course of evolution, you have this selection for different properties in their materials. And so they've kind of gone through the test bed of 450 million years of evolution. And we're simply now taking, one idea would be to take, understand how these structures work, understand their properties, understand how cells, in this case microbes, interact with them, and then be able to apply that to perhaps products or to human benefits.
Many of those insects in cold storage are cicadas that are found around Greensboro. So why study cicadas?
The reason we chose cicadas is that they're big.
Actually, the ease of handling a large insect isn't the only reason to study the bug.
This is the surface of the wing, just a microbe on it that has settled down and been affected by the features.
But to understand why the big cicada is so interesting, you have to look small, really small, to the cellular level. So small, a slice of cicada wing is mounted and examined using a scanning electron microscope.
Here it is. Okay, so there's a cicada wing right here. But when we zoom in on it, you'll notice that it's going to have a lot of actually features, that, and it's not just so flat. And this is kind of what we saw is the yeast would settle onto the surface, and then around it you can see how it's kind of pulling in, the features are kind of getting drawn in.
That's a super magnified image of a yeast cell on a cicada wing. The wing structures are about 50 nanometers tall. That's about 1,000 times smaller than the width of a human hair. Researchers want to understand the dynamics of the wing structure to figure out the property that kills microbes on contact.
So as we go through, you can see really well, though, the surface and then how it interacts with the yeast.
The questions are basic. What allows a cell to adhere to the wing surface, and then what tears that cell apart? Researchers are studying the wing's structure, its surface features, its mechanical properties, and its chemical makeup to understand what gives cicada wings those antimicrobial properties.
We discovered that cicadas in particular, cicadas local to Greensboro, have an anti-reflective property, a antimicrobial property, and an anti-wetting property. And so what I've attempted to do is mimic that in polymeric surfaces to see if I can extend the functions or translate the functions from the cicada wing to everyday materials.
And sometimes the best way to understand how something works is to build it. Doctoral student Kyle Nolan did just that, designing and creating tiny cicada wings in the lab out of plastic. And yes, those wings include those 50 nanometer tall structures.
The phenomenon was discovered in nature, and we're simply translating it to our materials.
And that's what's in here.
And that's what's, so this is an experiment that's underway. This is actually PET, it's a polymer. There were nanostructures fabricated in this surface, and now what we have is we have yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, brewer's yeast, incubating with this surface. And we're going to later prepare the samples for scanning electron microscopy, and we're going to image them and see what the cell morphology is after incubating on these surfaces, after attaching to the surfaces, and we're going to see what, you know, how the surface behaves, how the microbe behaves. You can either have the cells adhere and die, or you can simply repel the cells. Either one works. Perhaps, you know, some better for some applications than others. But that's, nonetheless, it's all interesting. It's fundamental science being done here.
Understanding the design, the mechanics, and the makeup of cicada wings could lead to scientific breakthroughs in the creation of medical instruments and in the fight against dangerous pathogens. And it all starts with a little bug.
If we had a big, juicy, you know, cicada, they can easily do it.
Okay, a little big bug.
It's really wild, isn't it? And it also makes you think how much more is out there.